The two shooting incidents in Chanja, a Kampala suburb, in a space of 1 week has shocked Uganda. The shootings claimed the lives of the State Minister for Labour, Charles Okello Engola, and Socialite Ibrahim Tusubira, also known as Isma Olaxis. Many questions remain.
Police, UPDF, everybody must join hand to fight these subversive activities, because the government, as government, we have enough money for the security operatives, then to control, also to check what is going on, because these killings is not okay.
But of course, even within the police, there is infighting, as you are aware. As we talk now, we don't know who is the director of ICT. Mr. Sewanyana, who has been the director, was first out, and the person who was supposed to come in never took office. So even as we talk now, we don't know whom we have to blame.
At Parliament, MPs are concerned that with all the huge investments in security in the last 5 years, there are still gaps being exploited.
You know, they were requesting that they need more cameras, they need all this, but I think now Ugandans have reached an extent of demanding now value for their money, in that with the insecurity that is cropping up and murders, we just need... Ugandans need an explanation.
Despite the fact that they have a huge budget, they have not invested much in human resource development. Because you have to take back these police officers for further training. They have to be equipped well. You have to facilitate them during investigations. In a situation where police is demanding me transport the complainant to go and facilitate them to go at the scene of crime, you cannot achieve justice in this country.
MPs faulted police on failing to conclusively investigate high-profile murders in Uganda.
What explanation can we get why up to now we have not get conviction for the people who killed Joan Kagezi or who killed Kawesi? Unless that issue is addressed, we are wasting time.
Still, to investigate a case, they request for fuel, they try to... siphon money from the complainant. That's a very big gap which need to be addressed, but that one is corruption.
The security forces need to step up their game, carry out investigations to the end, and report the findings to the public to restore confidence to the public. I think if they reported in this way, the public would take care on how to protect themselves.
Legislators have called for an audit into the CCTV project implemented by Uganda police to establish why crime rates remain high.
These cameras are mostly fixed on the main roads, but time and again, the roads are being constructed. When you go on the Jinja Road, Mukwano area, the Queensway, when you go on Jinja Road up to Mukono, where the fires broke out recently, you cannot get any starting point from the cameras. Why? Because there is construction going on the roads and the cameras were removed.
The MPs want the police to step up its mandate and inform the public on the way forward regarding crime intelligence. Report by Fred Kajubi for the news at Parliament.